Hello viewers, it's me Kulsoom Ahmed. Today we are going to learn about the introduction of economics. Economics is a social science that studies the choices that individuals, businesses, government and entire society make as they cope with the problem of scarcity. So scarcity means shortage of resources, and economics is the social science. Contrary to natural science, that is a branch of science which deals with the physical world, social science deals with the human behavior. For example, there are other types of as psychology, sociology, and political science. Economics is also the part of social science. So it is a dynamic subject that deals with the variations in the human behavior that happens while they are making different choices and in their buying habits and all that. Economics is taken from the Greek word oikonomia, that means management of a household administration. So at a household, we face economic problems. For example, money is coming to our home in the shape of our salary, and we use that money in making different choices to different things. For example, we have to pay utility bills, we have to buy grocery for the house. So all these things that we are managing are actually part of the household economy. So early in the morning, if we face economic problem, that is when we are brushing our teeth, we have to have brush and toothpaste. When we go for breakfast, when we go to school, we have to have a school bag and books. This is also the economic problem. And when we are looking for a job, this is also an economic problem. So every one of us are facing economic problems on a daily basis. So we have scarce resources, and we use those scarce resources in fulfilling our so many wants. For example, we want to have something, we want to eat something, and for example, if we want to buy a new car, and the same lines, if we want to buy a new household appliances, all these are the requirements that we require. These are our needs and wants. So all these are the things that we buy with the help of money. So money is the resource, and we are using that money in fulfilling our needs and wants. So there are two parts of economics, that is microeconomics and macroeconomics. Microeconomics deals with the millionth part of the economy. For example, when we talk about the choice of a single person, a single individual, the choice of a single firm, the choice of a single industry, all these are parts of the microeconomics. Whereas in macroeconomics, we talk about the aggregates, aggregate demand, aggregate supply, aggregate production, aggregate consumption. It means we are talking about the entire economy. So this is the macroeconomics. Let's see the different types of microeconomics examples. Single factory working in a country, a single train network out of so many transport means, this is also microeconomics. When we talk about the demand and supply of a single individual, when we talk about a single bank's performance, all these are the types of microeconomics. Whereas macroeconomics talks with the entire economic activities, for example, a stock market's activity. Stock market can do well, can do better when the things are in favorable condition, and it may go worse when things will go against. The same way, gross domestic product of a country can be very good, it can be very little when we have different economic recessionary conditions. The same type, on the same lines, we may face the problem of unemployment when economy will be in recession, or when we it could be when we impose minimum wage policy, so it may also cause so many people to be unemployed. Inflation is also a type of macroeconomics. When we are having inflation could be due to so many reasons. There might be a demand supply gap, there might be imported inflation when we buy things from abroad and we sell in our country, so it may cause imported inflation. These are types of macroeconomics. So microeconomic questions are, how does a market work, and what level of output does a firm produce? What price does a firm charge for goods it produces? How does a consumer determine how much of a good he or she will buy? All these are the types of microeconomic questions. On the other hand, we have macroeconomic questions. For example, how does the economy work? So economy might be in recession, it might be in boom, it might be in contractionary situation. What is unemployment? And sometimes it is high and sometimes low. So unemployment is also the type of macroeconomic question. What causes inflation? As I have explained before, why do some national economies grow faster than other national economies? For example, developed world is performing very good. Less developed countries might not perform good. So let's do some practice questions. Let's see what these are, whether these are microeconomic questions or macroeconomic. The unemployment rate in the United States was 5.2 in January 2005. So unemployment rate will fall under the category of macroeconomics. a US software firm discharged 15 workers last month and transferred the work to India. A US software firm means microeconomics, because we are talking about single US software firm. An unexpected freeze in Central Florida, this is also the type of microeconomic question. The same line, a US output adjusted for inflation, so this is the part of my microeconomic question. So this was all, and if you like my video, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.